There are many explanations why certain studies show, and it's mainly in breast cancer, that IGF-1 levels can be associated, linked to an increased risk of breast cancer. One of the reasons is that actually it may not be a cause of the cancer IGF, but a consequence. It has been shown that several tumors, breast tumors, malignant breast tumors, are able to produce IGF-1. So once you have a cancer cell, it produces IGF-1. It's more a consequence, a marker that there's something going on. Because other studies have shown that actually those tumors are breast tumors, are actually very low in receptors for IGF-1. That means that if IGF-1 is high, it doesn't work well. It's like we have insulin resistance, we have an IGF-1 resistance. Another study showed, for example, that the higher the IGF-1 levels are in a woman who has breast cancer, the more benign or the less dangerous this cancer is. The smaller the tumor, the less there's a risk of lymph node invasion, the less there's a risk of metastasis somewhere in the body of a new tumor of breast, breast tumor growing. So basically, most of the literature is relatively reassuring when you take into all the studies that have shown. Crotamine has been shown, for example, or IGF-1, which is to be linked, low levels are linked with more cancer of the cervix, the cervix of the uterus. This is normally a non-hormone dependent cancer, but it is a cancer that is promoted by low IGF-1 levels, up to 5 times more risk if you're in the lowest category of levels of IGF-1.